Hi, I'm Maya Kaczorowski, a product manager here at Tailscale, and I'm here with Mesam. Can you introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Mesam Ali. I'm an engineer here at Tailscale. I've been here for about 10 months. And it looks like we're here to talk about ACL tags today.
Yeah, that's right. So first off, what are access control lists, which people sometimes call ACLs or ACLs?
ACLs in the context of Tailscale specify which of your devices can communicate with which of your other devices. So you can specify something like, oh, Mesam's devices can talk to Maya's devices, or Maya's devices can only talk to Maya's own devices.
So how do I restrict it so that I can only talk to my own devices?
So you would go to the admin console in Tailscale and you would change the default allow all policy to say that Maya's devices can talk to Maya's devices. We have docs on how to use the correct policy syntax.
Got it. And correct me if I'm wrong, the policy is a default deny, so that unless I explicitly say something, two devices can't talk to each other.
Correct.
Got it. Any other way I can update the ACLs other than in the admin console?
So we also have an API, so you can like fetch and update the ACLs programmatically if you want.
Okay. So now that we know a bit more about ACLs, what are ACL tags?
That's a great question. When I get my laptop to join a Tailnet, it shows up in the admin console or in the Tailnet as Mesam's device. Or like if you were to sign in on your phone, it'll show up as Maya's device, right? Because you used your account to sign in.
And that makes sense, right? I'm logging in on my laptop. It's identified as being my laptop, right?
Correct. Right. It makes sense. But then there are certain types of devices like servers or shared internal analytics pipelines or whatever, in which they're not really tied to me. I might have worked on them when I was provisioning them initially, sure, but they have nothing to do with me after that fact. Right. So they should not be tied to my identity. They should be they should have their own permission model. And that's what ACL tags allows you to do.
And so what you're describing sounds a lot like something I've seen in other products called a service account, which is like a machine identity. How are ACL tags different from service accounts?
They are very similar, as you mentioned. They both apply to machines where there's no human associated with them. Service accounts live in your identity provider, or they come from your identity provider. And you can only typically have one service account per device. With ACL tags, you can actually have multiple tags per device. And that allows you to do more flexible policies. Like in my personal Tailnet, I have like a policy which says that infrastructure devices or devices that are tagged with infra can talk to all of the devices that are tagged with infra. But one of the infra devices is also a DNS server. And I want all of my other Tailnet devices to be able to talk to that on the DNS port. So I can like have multiple policies target the same node because of the way their tags are associated with that node.
I love that you have an infra tag in your personal Tailnet. What happens if I have more than one tag? So like if I have something that's tagged both, you know, production and tagged like Europe as an example.
When the policy engine is evaluating policies, it does so independently. So if you have a device, if you have a policy for tag Europe and you have a policy for tag broad, both of those would be applied to the device that has both of those tags. It is not that there's no intersection being applied here. It is always a union.
Got it. So part of the reason we're talking today is that ACL tags are becoming generally available, which is really exciting. What's new as part of the GA?
We wanted to improve the user experience around tag nodes in general. One of the biggest pain points was when a user who authenticated a tag node left the company, the tag node would also disappear with the user's account. This is something that we fixed in the GA launch. So tag nodes now stick around even if the user who authenticated them has left.
And that makes sense because before, you know, if you think about a laptop, right? If I leave, then you don't want my laptop on the tailnet anymore, but you probably still want the server that I provision because that's a shared resource.
Exactly.
Got it.
Another thing that we added was the ability to have auth keys that are tagged. So let's talk about auth keys a bit. Auth keys are this concept in Tailscale, which are keys or tokens that you can generate from the admin panel or the API that allows you to like provision Tailnet devices without going through the interactive login process. So you don't have to like sit there and click a URL or open the URL and hit the button. Whenever those devices would come up previously, they would be associated with my identity. They would not be tagged. But now you can specify a tag or an auth key. So whenever those devices originally come up in a Tailnet, they're automatically associated with the tag. So they're not ever tied with my identity.
Interesting. So when would I use an auth key with an ACLtech?
Turn-up automation is something that comes up pretty frequently. One of the things that I want is the ability to, if I have a CI/CD pipeline, I want the ability to spin up new devices that are joined my tailnet. Right now, I can give that deployment script or pipeline the auth key, and whenever it spins up a new machine, that machine will join my tailnet as the desired DAC.
So it's already restricted when it joins the tailnet to whatever ACLs you have in place. That's pretty cool. Exactly.
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
Got it.
Another thing that does come up with this same problem is now if I have to spin up like N types of machines, I either need N auth keys, or you can use this new concept where you can have a tag that can own other tags. So you can have a single auth key that is tagged with tag deployer or tag CI/CD, and that can have access to like provision your prod resources or provision your dev resources, whichever. So you can have a single auth key manage multiple tags.
That makes sense. So then rather than giving my deployment pipeline, five different auth keys, you know, one for prod and one for test and one for dev or whatever, I can just give it one auth key and then give it the ability to tag things. And then that's cool. Well, I learned a lot about ACL tags today. Very excited for the general availability. Thank you so much, Mesim.
Thank you, Maya.